We had an idea for the sequence in the basement. Half of that room was built in miniature. I mean, it was built full size, but it was also built in miniature. And you would cut from Michael Gross and Reba firing, and then you would cut to the miniature, and then you would cut to the full size, graboid. And I said, well, you know, there's another way we could connect the shot rather than in cuts. So I suggested an idea. I said, why don't we start on Michael Gross with the gun, and we pan off of him onto the miniature. We'll do a cut in the middle of the pan. Well, they were a little afraid to do that with the actor. But I suggested, why don't we have him drop one gun to go get another gun? Later on, we could get the same boots, the same shoes, and the gun, and the same piece of floor. We shoot it at our shop, drop the gun, pan off of it, and then pan onto the miniature, which was only a few feet away. That was a way to make it look like it, like they were right there in the room, without an optical. So we were trying to come up with ideas that might avoid opticals because that's more expensive. And we weren't quite set up to do opticals yet. Actually, it was at that point where we started talking about opticals that I suggested Gene Warren do some of the shots.
Did a lot of elements on Tremors. Knowing Gale Ann Hurd from the first Terminator and many movies with her after, she came to us, wouldn't say to do any fix-up work, because most of the work that was done in Tremors by the Scos holds up today, but to try and spice up a few things. For instance, when he comes through the wall, and the husband and wife are just blowing away at him, shooting him up, and we just add some more bullet holes. Without the bullet hits, it just looks like he's jerking around and he's trying to bite you. Just adding these little bullet hits to him, showing the audience that he's being hit, and nothing's happening.